I felt like that about anybody who worked in our house, whether as a servant, I never called them servants, helpers, or our children, that if they did not see Christ in me and my wife, there was something wrong. What did they see then? Did they see us? I'm not saying perfection. I made many mistakes in bringing up my children. I've often punished them in anger. And I would always, almost immediately after punishing them, rush off to the bathroom, lock the door, and really repent and weep before God. Over a period of time, my children discovered what I was doing. I didn't feel that they were old enough to understand an apology from me, because if every time I punished them in anger, I apologized for my anger, it would become a joke to them that they would think that I was apologizing for disciplining them, which I was not. But they wouldn't know the difference. So I gave them one consolidated apology when they were 18 years old, when they were leaving home, for all the years when I punished them in anger. They were old enough then to understand the difference between anger and discipline. But I was really felt bad about it, because I knew the anger was wrong, the discipline was right. And because I repented and wept before God, it became better. And that applies to not only discipline, but any other area where you fail as a father or a mother or a husband or a wife. If you are quick to repent, there's great hope for you. I want to tell you that. None of us come to perfection like that. We press on to perfection. See, one of the accusations people make against CFC is, you guys think you're perfect and the rest of Christendom is not. I said, just come to our church building and see what's written on our pulpit. It's written we must press on to perfection. That is the clearest testimony on our pulpit that we are not perfect. I said, it's you guys who don't preach press on to perfection who think you're perfect. Do you ever preach on pressing on to perfection? No. Well, you must be thinking you're perfect.